Hello students, in the previous session we learned about introduction to alcoholic beverages, where we talked about what are the different types of alcoholic beverages, what are non-alcoholic beverages and alcoholic beverages, and then we further classified alcoholic beverages. In today's session we are going to start beer. It's an alcoholic beverage which is fermented. In this session, we are going to learn about introduction of beer, history of beer, beer ingredients, and then production process. Introduction of beer. Beer is the world's oldest and most widely consumed alcoholic drink. It is the third most popular drink overall after water and tea. The production of beer is called brewing, which involves the fermentation of sugar, mainly derived from cereals and grain. Starches, most commonly from malt, barley, although wheat, maize, and rice are widely used throughout the world. Most beer is flavored with hops, which adds bitterness and act as a natural preservative. The credit of brewing goes to the nomadic tribes in Middle East. By 6000 BC, brewing was well established in Babylon. The Egyptian, Greeks and the Roman all produced beer of good quality. Coming to the ingredients of beer, we have barley, water, hops, yeast, sugar and finings. Water. In brewing parlance, it is called liquor. Hard water is ideal for lager. Soft water is more suitable for heavier beer like bitters. Barley. Varieties of Hordeum sativum are used. Low protein, maize otter and pipkin barley are preferred. Protein causes cloudiness, so less protein barley are used. Barley enzymes are called diastase. Diastase is an enzyme which converts the starch into sugar, and that is very vital for fermentation. Next we have hops. Hops come from mulberry family. These are kind of creepers. The technical name is Humulus lupulus. Outstanding varieties are Fugal, which is from England, Golding, which is again from England, Northern Brewers, Saaz, which is from Czechoslovakia. The hop is a herbaceous climbing plant. As I said, these are creepers. Flowers of the cone part of the female hop vine is used, and the functions of hops are as follows. They provide aroma, they act as an antiseptic agent, they provide flavor, they also act as filter bed during the production process, and they also act as preservative in the beer. Next, we have a very vital and a critical component in the beer making process as yeast. So there are two types of yeast which are used in beer making process. One is Saccharomyces cerevisiae, which is used in top fermented beers, and the second one is Saccharomyces carlsbergensis, which is used in bottom fermented beers. During the process of learning beer making process, we will understand how these two yeast differentiate the process of beer making. The next ingredient is sugar. Now, sugar is not actually an ingredient, but yes, it forms a major part of beer making process, because barley which we are using is going to be used as a sugar. Now, the starch which is there in the barley will be converted to sugar, and the steps for the conversion will be discussed in the manufacturing process. So, the most important thing is the starch of barley will be converted to sugar. and then the sugar will act as an ingredient. The sugar is the invert which facilitate the fermentation in the form of priming sugar, used to add sweetness to brown ales and sweet stouts beer. Now these are two categories of beer where extra sugar is added to make them more sweet. They are brown ales and sweet stout beer. Next we have finings. Again, this is also not an ingredient. These act as a clarifying agent. So they are used to clear the beer. So fining act as a clarifying agent, and the most widely used fining agent is icing glass. It is the bladder of sturgeon fish, and it's a classical fining agent used throughout the world. So that's it for this session. In the next session, we are going to learn about beer manufacturing process. So stay tuned in. Thank you.